Okay. So this is what happened. And it wanted to make improvement on agriculture and promotion of the welfare and prosperity of the rural population. But the land revenue and land tenure excluded from the terms of the commission. That problem was there. So how can they improve the prosperity and welfare of this rural people? This was happened in 1928. Now some of the people of the commission said, actually everything is not the problem. The problem in India was to improve the Indian village life. This land fragmentation, giving this land, that land without any IR, this giving extra tax and all, has to be stopped. Otherwise how will the people live? Then they planned they should establish an Imperial Council of Agricultural Research, which would provide guidance to the areas to improve agricultural production. They are not thinking about the people. Small actions were taken by the British provinces. This made sure they only were wanting to increase the improve the situation of the agriculture in India. The challenge they were facing was actually from the famines and the resultant unrest between the people. They also wanted to increase the farm production. One was irrigation facilities, cooperative societies, and a research committee. The peasants did not take it seriously. So what the hell is happening? By the first quarter of 20th century, freedom movement reached the villages. The non-cooperation movement, there was no tax payment movement. The awakening which came to the peasants brought home the fact that the British government was doing all for its own interest and the welfare of the peasants was alien to them. What's my point? They only wanted revenue, they did not want people to, if you die, die, no problem. Now what did the non-government organization do? When the British eye was on the improvement of the agriculture, our leaders were engaging all and mobilizing all the village people for their involvement in the freedom movement. Major challenge was the 1857 revolt, when the All India Congress Committee foundation happened. The village people were organized. It was the beginning of the 20th century. Particularly during the non-corporation movement, 1920 and 1922, our national leaders took up constructive works for the awakening of people. Large number of voluntary organizations came into the country. These organized based themselves in the villages. Constructive work was going on, opening schools, adult classes, hostels, led the villages to implement the plans which could give self-reliance to them. National leaders convinced that freedom could only be gained with the participation of masses of people. No history of village development could be complete without description of the voluntary organization which worked among villages. Beside the Gandhian workers, some more moral organizations and missions such as the Ramakrishna Mission, which also worked for the upliftment of the villagers, even Christian missionaries, though they had their interest in religious conversion, also worked in the field of education, health and sanitation. Thousands of social workers worked among the villagers for causes of development. This came and this the British did not do. The voluntary organizations could not provide any physical infrastructure to the villages because they are non-government, they don't have that money. But they definitely provided social education to the villagers to fight against social evils of illiteracy, intoxication, parda and backwardness of women. These reforms were not any ordinary, these are very tough reforms. Okay. Seva Gram Ashram. Gandhiji had a definite idea about Indian villages. Throughout his life, he fought for the poor people, the village people. Gram Swaraj or village autonomy was his often repeated theme. Always argued villages should be given the power to rule themselves. Inspired by this ideology, he established the Sabarmati Ashram at Ahmedabad. This ashram in the beginning was in a village outside the walled city. Later on in 1935, Sevagram Ashram, it was based in Wardha and imparted education to the weaker section of the villages surrounding Wardha. Development programs for the villages at Wardha included sanitation, adult education, promotion of village industries such as telkhani, making oil and potable water. The villagers were encouraged to fulfill their own needs and not to seek any help from the government. British are going down. Wardha Ashram had this promotion of Bunyadi Siksha or basic education for the development of villages. Everyone should have some education. He was against the formal school education which depended on largely on only lectures like me. Basic knowledge we must have. That's why I'm not going with your book. You must have the basic knowledge of what was actually happening during that time. Why did people go ahead and change? Why did we go ahead to the freedom fight? It should be vocational education. At the school level, the children should be educated to do their own work from cooking to cleaning and spinning. It's not only question answers. Self-dependence. Every village should fulfill all its needs by itself. Don't be dependent on anything. Suppose, I give a small example to you. You sleep in the bed. You sleep on the bed. You get up in the morning. Who arranges your bed? You or your mother? If you do it, awesome. But if you don't do it, start doing it. Get disciplined. Don't be dependent on anybody. Do your work yourself. It will make you a better human being. Don't wait. Do it. This constructive work style of the Wardha Ashram was started in different parts of the country. So automatically this information is going around the country. Gandhiji's economy revolved around the charkha, village industries and manual work. I am only emphasizing on that a network of voluntary agencies based in the villages gave the message to the people that the village to attain self-sufficiency in all aspects of life. Then I come to our Bengal, Shantiniketan. Rabindranath Tagore was inspired by him. Quite like Gandhiji, was influenced by the idea that village should stand on its own legs. Tagore did not like the crowded life of Calcutta. He therefore started his ashram a little away from Calcutta and thought Shantiniketan today has the status of a university. He had started it by bringing people, village people, closer to the young people. Shantiniketan educational part is actually very close to village life, sanitation, health, cottage industry and welfare. It did not provide any infrastructures to the surrounding villages. It created an awakening among the villagers to develop self-reliance. It became a total place for Bengal. Imitation, ideal imitation. People wanted to copy, but you will never get a place like that. Beautiful place. Then came the flood of literary works came into our country. I'll keep it till there today and we'll come back next time and I'll again explain and then I'll tell you, then we'll finish this chapter. Okay? So see you, take care and stay safe. Take care of yourselves. Bye bye. I hope I was able to explain.